What you got there?
Hey, my guy's bored.
Up next is Marlene Hardick, I believe. Is she back there? Oh, okay. Well, before we go on, Marlene, I want to tell them about the story about how we first met. She has a dog who can talk and sing, as you're going to see, and you probably didn't know this, and I didn't know this until I was driving past her house. I did not know where she lived. But I drove past her house and saw a sign out front that said, "Talking dog for sale, $10. I see, that's a lot of talks, right? So I go in there, and I knock on the door. Dog comes to the door, "What you want?" "I want you to talk." And he says, "Well, Marlene's out back, she's in the yard." And I'm like, "Well, just a second here. Explain to me how it is that you can talk and we don't know about this. I mean, how's this?" He says, "Well, I discovered at a very young age that I was able to talk. So I immediately, my master contacted the government. They sent me to work for the CIA. They sent me all across the world. I've been in the Kremlin. I've been to the Middle East. I've worked with spies. Nobody ever suspected a dog of A, eavesdropping, and B, being able to tell someone what happened and that I was relaying this information." So I'm like, "Wow, that's great. What? Here. Well, I got tired of that. I got a little burned out at the CIA, you can imagine. And went to work a little airport security, you know, not just sniffing the suitcases and stuff, but actually just kind of eavesdropping, doing the same thing, could be like information out of grumpy people at TSA. And, you know, hung that up, retired, had a wife, made some puppies, and, you know, we're just hanging out here at Marlene's house." "Oh, all right. Well, where's Marlene? And so I go back up, Marlene's working in her bed. I buy your dog, I give you $20 for the dog. It's amazing he talks. Why do you want to sell him?" She goes, "That liar, he's never done any of that." Are you ready, Marlene? All right, here we go. You need something or?
This is a little embarrassing. We signed up to leap over the church with a single bound. This is Sierra Mist, the soda pup, and the wonder dog. And then 3 weeks ago, she had surgery. And the doctor said, "Leap over the church with a single bound? No way." So instead, Misty's going to hula hoop for you. Now, we need an assistant for this.
Me?
Is so we're gonna one table at a time here. All right, let's give it your best here. One more time. Very good. Let's see if you can do better. One more time. Can you remember that now? Remember? That's your part. Okay, right here. And then we're gonna divide the room in half here. So this half, when I point to you, you do the arf-arf part. But you also sing the refrain with us. Same thing here. I point here. You guys do the arf-arf. All right, let's see if we can figure this out. I need two strong people to assist.
Well, that would be me.
All right, we have one. Okay, another strong person. Strong person. Oh, he can do it by himself. Oh, wow.
Scott, sit down.
All right.
Yeah. All right, I didn't expect that. Okay, here we go.
Where's your collar?
Okay, everybody sang the first time. Everybody does the arc arcs. Here we go.
How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the wiggly tail. How much is that doggy in the window? I do hope that doggy's for sale.
California and leave my poor sweetheart alone. If he has a dog, he won't be lonely, and the doggy will have a good home.
How much is that dog in the window?
Shine in the dark. If he has a dog, he won't be scared, and the dog will scare the robbers with one bark.
Bark, bark.
How much is that dog in the window? The one with the wiggly tail. How much is that dog?
Window.
The one with the waggly tail.
Sierra missed the soda pop. Raise your hand high. This is where the band throws it into the audience. Thank you very much.